Good evening. Welcome to Reality Check. On the show tonight, my colleague Uma Sudhir's special series of reports coming up next on the water situation in Chennai, where water supply has been cut by 40%. The consequences are huge for millions in the city. At 8:30, something completely different. I interview the former Miss India who decided to stand up to goons who attacked her Uber taxi in Kolkata. We discuss the issue of road rage, a peril in our cities which is almost never discussed. But first, let's go straight across to Uma for the latest on the rather desperate situation in Chennai. Uma.
Yes, indeed. A good evening to you from Chennai. Things here looking quite bleak. In fact, everyone worried and everyone is after one thing only in Chennai, and that is water. We have been talking about a city that's said that its, you know, late monsoon arrival can be blamed, and 63% monsoon in the last year can be blamed. And the previous year we spoke about a 140-year worst drought in 140 years. That's what it was called in 2017. You will also recall that in 2015, we had an excess of water, and everywhere around, we were talking about water, water everywhere and everything getting submerged and how to not have floods in a city like Chennai. I'm here in Roypeta, in fact, in an apartment complex. This would be considered really the heart of Chennai. If you're talking about only the suburbs and the outward lying areas suffering, I'm going to ask residents what it is like here. In fact, I'm going to pick you first because you're the president of this welfare association. You're all well-to-do people and you are not having a water crisis at all. Is that the situation here?
No, not at all. We are definitely having a lot of water crisis. We are not able to have peaceful nights because we don't know whether we will get any water at all the next day. That's the life we are leading, and it's only becoming worse. And it's very unfortunate because till recently we were fairly well off. But it's getting worse by the day, and all the borewells that we are trying.
Our chief minister says that this is an exaggeration. Your municipal administration minister, Mr. Velumani, says that this is all manufactured news.
What today the water will come. Alternate days only we'll get water. So the house which is above this her house.
There are only certain parts of our area we get water. So she doesn't get water at all.
No, he will pump and he will inform her. Yeah. So next she will pump. Then after they pump, it will come to our street. We are at the tail end. So we have to pump and bring water.
You are in a VIP area. You are just mentioning that you have big political party headquarters and also chief ministers, former chief ministers in the area.
Yeah, definitely. We, of course, stay in the heart of the, Chennai city. But still, both the ruling parties, opposition parties are there. Still, we are fighting for water. See, we daily hear lots of news of people killing each other for water, but hopefully we don't have such things here. But still, we are suffering with without water, proper water. It's like daily we have to get up and keep telling the kids, servants, husbands. We have big fights for that with husbands that please do not waste water. See, tomorrow we don't know how it is going to happen. And they're all used to open up the showers and take nice showers. Now they are. Have to take.
Now you ration how much of water can be used.
Yeah, definitely. Half the bucket.
You as a joke told me that you all didn't wash the face, and yeah. I said, is it a joke? But you said, no, it's not a joke.
No, it is real only, because I didn't wash my face also. Because the water will come at 8 o'clock only. By 8:30 it goes up, so I didn't wash my face. I'm just going back to Bombay. Because I want to stay here for 10 days. But as
your sister has said, not welcome because guests are not welcome at this point in time. Is that right?
Yeah, better. Whoever comes
better
to my house. No, whoever comes to my house, I would expect them to bring some fruits or something. Now it's better they come with their own water bottles, so that at least I don't have to cater to them. And tankers here is a real problem.
The metropolitan water supply, they say 40% down. Mm. Many areas not getting piped water at all. So you're depending on tankers.
Yeah, much tankers. Because metro tankers, we have booked, it comes after a month. So private tankers, we have to pay almost 10 times.
Which is how much?
It's 5,500. My only question is, if a private tanker can give me water, why can't my government give?
You said you had booked a water tanker when?
23rd May, I booked my water tanker through Metro, online facility. Still, I haven't received the water tanker.
So how are you managing in the meantime?
We are praying that the borewell don't run out of water. and it's really a tough situation. That's why I wear shorts most of the time. I try to, you know, wash my dhotis once a week or something like that, try to manage the situation. Also inform our, you know, housemates to follow the same. This is really difficult, yeah.
I booked 2 rooms in Swagat Hotel.
Oh, God.
If I have no water in the house, I'll go and stay there. Oh. I'm going to stay there.
You have actually done that?
Yeah.
In fact, I've heard many friends and relatives who mentioned that their friends had moved to other cities if they are able to. I mean, people who may not have jobs, retired people. Is that happening actually?
Yeah, that's true. Somebody
there are parts of Chennai who are receiving better water supply. The thing is, there are, my sister lives in Kalakshetra Colony. She has no problem. My Samani lives in Maremalai Nagar. He has no problem. I mean, in relative
sense.
You're
talking about areas which are better off, but I have in fact travelled around city today, and the areas that we visited, perhaps because the pots caught our eyes, you will see lines and lines which are almost kilometre long of pots, and people have been waiting since early morning. Let's take a look at this report from Anakaputtur, which is really a suburb of Chennai near Pallavaram.
This area is called, in fact, the Ammankoil bus stop, and that's where you can see these colorful buckets lined all over, and this goes on almost endlessly. If I'm going to pan that side and actually show you a board that says that water is going to be available in the morning between 6 and 9 and 5 and 8 in the evening. That sounds very nice. That says drinking water available between 6 and 9 and 5 and 8. Every street like this is supposed to happen. But residents here telling us that the water comes only once in a month. And this is one of those rare pipes where they're actually having water more frequently. And that's the reason everybody here lines up. Okay. So what they're saying is that when they do get water, they manage to fill some 10 pots. But if she doesn't get the water, then she has to buy water, each of these pots, for 10 rupees each, and therefore 100 rupees for 10 pots of water. And this is supposed to be drinking water, which is of course very, very precious here, because if you even ask for private tankers to come in, if the Chennai Metro Water is going to sell you water for about 700 rupees, the private tankers which are bringing in 9,000 liters of water, they will cost up to 3,500 rupees. I'll just give you the differential between last year. Someone was just telling me that if they bought water for 1,500 rupees, a 9,000 litre private tanker, this time round they have to pay up to 4,000 or 5,000 rupees. There's absolutely no reliability that the water can still come. For all these women, in fact, it's a long, long wait. They're arguing with each other about how many pots of water they can get. She's come at 4 in the morning to wait here. Not able to eat well, not able to cook well, because their entire energy goes in
fridge.
அரசியல்வாதிங்க யாரும் வந்து இதுக்கு பதில் சொல்றது இல்லையா? இப்ப நம்ம
தானே
the anger that no one comes to ask now about the water crisis, whereas otherwise there is huge problems. Ninge idellam thanni ipo thookin ponu athukku kadichu enakka lucky da
aal theru thalli ponu avla daily 6 mani nu solittu 9 mani urukku thanni eppadi avla
appo late ipdi queue vekka vendiyadha
aama.
What he's telling us is that every day they have to spend the mornings like this, because at around 4 or 5 they start lining up for this, and he has been waiting from 6 in the morning, and at around 8 or 9 o'clock the water starts coming, and even though he has to carry it about 4 streets away, he and his wife, even then they feel lucky if they are able to get those 4 pots of water, so that at least the day is taken care of, their necessities for the day are taken care of, because this is obviously a middle class locality, and having to pay for this kind of water is a very, very difficult task. This is a scenario we are in fact seeing all across the city, because of the fact that the 4 drinking water sources, including Chembrambatham Lake, at their you know, almost bone dry, I must say. Our correspondent Sam Daniel, my colleague, had also reported from there showing how parched that area was. And this is a city which just 4 years ago you would recall into, you know, had floods, Chennai floods we called them. And yet rainwater harvesting has not happened and those structures have not worked. And more importantly, people here also telling me that desalination of water, which would have been a 25 crore project, that's something that they spoke about all the time. But instead, the money, they say, one that person at least suggested, was diverted for something like metro rail, which perhaps only 1 lakh people use. But if a desalination plant had come, this kind of crisis would not come for people, people having to give up all their other work and spending hours together just filling water.
When there is a water crisis, everyone is affected, from the elderly, the senior citizens, the people who have to go to work, and also children. People are going to work. In fact, many officers, we are being told in the IT sector, no company will admit it publicly. They are asking employees to stay at home and do their work so that they don't use the washroom facilities. Some of them have locked up a couple of washrooms, if they have 4 of them, and try to ensure that employees don't really use excess of water. There are posters everywhere telling you, please use water carefully. Children here, are your parents telling you not to stand under the shower for too long? Or are they even allowing you to use the shower?
No. Yeah, but no.
No way.
In our school, they continuously tell us that we shouldn't use plastic, so that then they dump that plastic in the seas. It gets polluted and we waste that water also.
Very, very good point, actually. And it actually does not allow the seepage of water into the ground. Your mom was just mentioning that she got her hair cut because yeah. She doesn't have to use excess water, and she got her own hair cut as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, we literally had to change our hairstyle because there was a lot of water shortage. And washing our hair with a full bucket of water, our mom used to keep nagging us every day, stop using so much water, there's no water everywhere and all that. So we literally changed our hair.
So anything else that you're doing as youngsters, and do you realize that, or do you think this is the new normal, or do you feel that you can do something about it? No idea.
We can obviously save water.
Even adults don't have any ideas about what exactly we can do. Yes, we do know that these are things that are recommended.
Nothing. Like, I just want to tell you one thing. It's so difficult for a homemaker to cooking. It's like I have to plan everything from morning to evening. I finish my cooking in a 1 hour job. The whole day is like no water. I keep screaming
waiting
at my kids. Yeah, waiting for the water and keep screaming at my kids. Please don't waste water. That's it.
We can wash. Yeah. Does your menu also at home change to ensure that water is less? Because I was being told, in fact, you were mentioning that schools are asking children to bring tiffins,
yes,
which are dry, so that they don't have
so they don't have to use water. It's true. Quite a few schools have been told if the same situation continues, they will have to get dry lunch for school. And water from no water from school. Quite a few schools, in fact, stop you keeping even water bottles in the school.
Asking the children themselves to get the water. Any other measures that you're hearing about? Because I know there are some prominent schools that are asked actually reducing their timing of.
Not about the school, because my kids have already, you know, flown away in terms of like they moved away from beyond school. So we are lucky that way that, you know, we don't have children at home. So managing water is a bit more easier fact.
Yeah. What we in fact noticed was that in the lower socioeconomic classes perhaps, or even in the middle classes, fetching water becomes a family activity, and children actually turn into water soldiers, not just to keep that line in the morning so that the pots remain intact. Elderly also used for that. And in cases where children are not having to fetch the water, they are being told school hours are being curtailed. Take a look at this report. This child Shalini also carrying water, trying to help out along with the other adults. She in fact is going to afternoon school now. Thanni problem eppadi irukku
illa konja kashtama irukku romba kashtama thookave mudiyala
kashtama irukku ana help pannaama mudiyadhu periya ungalku ungala mari kuzhandhaigal la help pandringala
ha help pannala
veetla thanni illadhanaala enna prachnai
engalukku kulika mudiyala thuni thuvaikka mudiyala saama theekka mudiyala indha prachana da irukku
டெய்லி வருதா இங்க தண்ணி
இல்ல ஒரு நாள் விட்டு தான் வருது ஆக்சுவலா
ஓகே சோ ஷீ சேஸ் ஓன்லி ஆன் ஆல்டர்னேட் டேஸ் ஷீ இஸ் ஏபிள் டு கெட் வாட்டர் அண்ட் சில்ட்ரன் ஆல்சோ பிச்சன் இஃப் யூ ஜஸ்ட் பேன் இன் ஃபேக்ட் யூ வில் சீ தட் சைல்ட் கேரிங் அ ஸ்கூல் பேக் ஹூ இஸ் ஆல்சோ ஹேண்டிங் ஓவர் பாட்ஸ் ஆஃப் வாட்டர் பாட்ஸ் இன் விச் வாட்டர் இஸ் டு பி ஃபில்ட்
So this is in fact a 10th class child who is going to run the cycle. Ivare kutin povar at cycle kondu povar. So he goes, he takes this and he will go away in his cycle so that his mother doesn't have to carry it. So you help your mother. Evlo manikku school ipo?
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock. Yeah, time aidichu. Yeah. But can't be helped because that's the way. Okay, you can go. So that's the kind of tasks that children are also expected to pitch in and work for the family, because otherwise it's not possible to really survive. So this child also helping his mother fill up. What happens is that I've seen several elderly people there. You can see elderly people as well who are who come in first and who then manage to kind of given this. Sorry, I'm going to once again deflect and show you that shot of them going away. How many pots of water are there? There are going to be about 8 pots of water. Radha carries one pot, and the 6 pots is being carried by her son Ajay, who's only about 15 years old. He's just gone to 10th class, and helping his mother carry the water back home. It's at least a couple of streets away her home. And here, as I was telling you, these elderly people usually stationed in order to ensure that their place in the queue is kept intact. They have to come here at 3 or 4 in the morning to ensure that they are first in the queue and ensure that the place is kept. They will ensure that the water is filled, perhaps also ensure that somebody else doesn't get in front in the line and go away with the water, precious water. And then the other more able-bodied family members will come in and they will fetch the water and carry it back home. Other than teaching students to conserve water, some emergency measures are also being undertaken, like this school, which has about 30 branches across Chennai. And they have said that from Monday onwards, the school will work half day between 8 and 12:15 because of scarcity of water. Youngsters, seniors, all very affected. Ma'am, you were sharing about the experience of elders, which in fact is almost pathetic.
I should talk on behalf of myself and the rest of the area, because I have my mother and mother-in-law who are 89-year-old living with me. In summer, they have a very delicate system. No? They tend to use the restroom more often. The thing is, they are now so afraid of the water problem, they say, let me eat less so that I will not use the restroom, you know. It really hurts to see them, because they will not listen to me even if I try to convince them, because they know what we are going through. And I'm not talking for myself, because there are a lot of households in our area where people have been living for ages, 40, 50 years. They are all in their past 80s now, some of them bedridden. And everyone is finding it difficult to support the old people the way we would like to support them, you know. We are not able to give them quality care.
And safety.
Past 1 week, we are using only plantain leaf, plantain dry leaf for eating breakfast, lunch. So that because we can save water by washing our plates.
You don't need to wash the vessel.
Washing the rice and all. Cleaning water, we'll collect and we'll pour it in the plants. So the plants, also survive, at least.
We need the plants.
Yes, we need the plants. So
what we have in fact found across the city was that many places, almost all the areas that I visited, borewells had run dry. And in areas which have perhaps for the last 20 to 25 years not seen that kind of groundwater levels going down, that's what is happening now. Take a look at this report from Chitlapakkam. We are here in Chitlapakkam, and this is the status of several wells here. Wells that have dried up. In fact, this is an area that didn't really have a water shortage. I have with me Kanagi Ramachandran. Ninga inge 20 varshamave irutittu irukinga. Eppadi irundhathu prachana indha varsham eppadi irukku?
20 varsham 22 varshama irukrom naanga inge. ஆனால் இது வரைக்கும் தண்ணி பிரச்சனை வந்ததே கிடையாது. இந்த கிணத்துலையும் தண்ணி இருக்கும். இப்போ ஆனால் இப்போ ஒரு 7 இயர்ஸாக கிணத்து தண்ணி கிடையாது. போர் போட்டோம். போரில் 10 வருஷமாக போரில் தண்ணி எடுக்கிறோம். ஆனால் இது வரைக்கும் எங்கே தண்ணி இல்லாட்டமாலும் எங்கள் இதில் தண்ணி இருந்துக்கிட்டு தான் இருக்கும். ஆனால் இந்த வருஷம் தான் எங்களுக்கு இப்போ கிட்டத்தட்ட ஒரு 3 மாதமாக எங்களுக்கு போரில் தண்ணி கிடையாது. ரொம்ப கஷ்டமாக இருக்குது.
So what she's explaining is that this well used to always have water. Last few years, in fact, they have stopped drawing water from this, but they have been using bore wells, and even that was working, and they were in a condition of surplus. But this year, they are suffering hugely. Private tankers are நம்பி இருக்கீங்களா? எப்படி? பைப்பில் வர்றதா தண்ணி?
பைப்பில் வர்றதில்லை. ஆனால் லாரி தண்ணி, லாரியில் வாங்கி லாரி தண்ணி ஹெவி ரேட் சொல்கிறாங்க இப்போவெல்லாம். இருந்தாலும் தண்ணி கஷ்டத்துக்கு என்ன செய்யறதுன்ட்டு வேறு வழி இல்லாமல் அதை வாங்கி டேங்கில்
எவ்வளவு ரேட்டெல்லாம் இருக்குது?
முன்னாடியே இப்போ சாதாரணமாக வந்து இப்போது 1 இயருக்கு முன்னெல்லாம் கொடுத்தவங்கலாம் 6,000 வந்து 6,000 தண்ணி வந்து 700, 800 இப்படி கொடுத்துக்கிட்டு இருந்தாங்க. இப்போ வந்து 600 தண்ணி வந்து 2,000 சொல்கிறாங்க. 2,000, 2,500 இந்த மாதிரி தான் சொல்றாங்க வேற வழி அவங்களுக்கு தண்ணி கிடைக்கலங்கறாங்க எங்களுக்கு தண்ணி
சோ தி வாட்டர் ரேட்ஸ் ஹவ் ரியலி டபுள்ட் ஆர் ட்ரிபிள்ட் இஃப் நாட் இன்கிரீஸ்ட் மோர் இன் பிரைஸ் அண்ட் தட்ஸ் தி ரீசன் வை பீப்பிள் ஆர் ஹியூஜ்லி சஃபரிங் ஐ மஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட் அவுட் தட் இன் ஃபேக்ட் இன் தீஸ் வெரி ஏரியாஸ் வி ஹவ் ரிப்போர்ட்டட் அட் த டைம் ஆஃப் சென்னை ஃப்ளட்ஸ் அண்ட் வி சா ஹவுசஸ் தட் வேர் சப்மர்ஜ்ட் இன் வாட்டர் அண்ட் நவ் தி ஸ்கேர்சிட்டி ரியலி ரிஃப்ளெக்ட்ஸ் தி imbalance between ability to save waters when they are in excess and then being able to use them in times of scarcity. The situation when you don't have bore wells that have any water, you don't get water in your water pipe and the metropolitan water supply is not able to give you water. Many of these private tankers say in fact that they are getting water from very far off distances, perhaps from the quarries and other places. That's the reason for the high cost. But do you also believe that there is some kind of a mafia operating here because of which you are mentioning very, very high rates of water and very long waits when you are depending on the government supply?
Yeah, we are really surprised how 5,200 for some 9,000 liters, it won't even last for 2 to 3 days. Then water will, even those tankers, as the demand is increasing, they are increasing the rates also. This 5,000 next time, next week, maybe it will be 7 and it may even cross 10,000 rupees.
In fact, the irony is that Chennai had seen floods in 2015 and even at that time we spoke about clearing out the waterways so that it can be led into places where it can seep into the grounds and the groundwater levels can go up. Are people taking rainwater harvesting and such messages seriously?
Yeah, they have to take. There are some people who are, and there are some people who are not yet getting the seriousness of the plan.
Where does water go?
Yeah, they have to make sure whatever water collects in the concrete, you have to find a space where you can, you know, dig a pipe which goes into the ground so that the water table level goes up. But ironically, something has happened in our area. The stormwater drain people have dug up and successfully broken all our supply lines. So instead of helping us, actually the main supply line also has been broken and that has added to our woes.
In fact, we visited a home that we had in fact visited in December 2015 after the Chennai flooding incident, and at that time the house, the ground floor was submerged, and now they have a situation where they have not a drop of water in the home. Take a look at this report from once again the Chitlapakam area. The irony of the contrast that Chennai has been experiencing. In December 2015, we had come to this very house. In fact, it was submerged in water, and the residents, in fact, Mr. Ramakrishnan, had shown us all the furniture gone, everything underwater. And in fact, I think that's almost the mark till which we had water, and we were trying to wade through. It was almost till here that the water was there. And his wife, in fact, had to be transported upstairs at a time when she had just suffered a stroke. Now the condition is that there is no water at all, and they have installed a tank for 1 lakh rupees. I have with me Vardhini. Your father was telling us how they lost everything, and even now you keep it locked because this place gets flooded if there are rains.
Hello ma'am, and actually I am Vardhini here. I am the daughter of our Rangaramakrishnan. In 2016, this place was flooded with so much of water.
2015 probably.
15, I think it is 15 December. And it was so much of water there. And now we have spent so much of money, more than 1 lakh my brother spent. And 4,000 liters of capacity water tank we have. And the water has not stored properly during the rainy season. We feel that is the reason all the people in Chennai, we are suffering without water.
Mr. Ishwaran, seems really ironic, isn't it, that you have flooding on the one side. I remember this place was flooded and we actually waded through water and came here. Yeah. And now there is a drought.
Now there is no water, yeah. All the furnitures have been submerged during the rainy season. Now there is no water at all. Now the
so that your brother-in-law shifted out. Actually.
Shifted out, yeah. He shifted from here because of that water problem. He has shifted. Now there is no water. We are under a severe drought. And
what do you want to tell the government? Isn't it better water management that we really are looking for?
Yes, during rainy season, the government has to take proper steps to store the water. Even from not only animals, even small children are suffering without water. We have come from Muscat for holidays. When we come here, we feel the people, and when we see our parents suffering for water, and my brother, he shifted to another place, and my parents are also not,
they are too elderly,
they are not able to shift. That's why my brother shifted. He also has a small child, and he has to take care of the family, and he is spending lots of money. During rainy season also he spends so much money, and now also he is spending so much of money.
So irony of excess water as well as no water causing distress to families and huge amount of expenditure. If there is a water crisis, what are people going to do, and how are houses really looking? Take a look. Many homes in Chennai now have tanks all over the place, because if you don't have piped water, what option do you have but to buy the water? So that is what you are doing, sir. Vaanga vendi varudhu paisa, you have to buy the water.
Yes. Appa monthly vandu ungalku oru trip vandu ungalku 2000 rupees interest, sorry 1000 rupees interest extra annual 2000.
So you have to pay for almost four days of supply. You are paying 2000 rupees. That means you are spending a huge amount of money.
Yes, more month in about 7000.
So that is the kind of money that they are spending. You can see that there are tanks all over. There are tanks inside as well. They say, telling us that there are about four families here. Every home almost has tanks like that, in fact. The family here telling us that they have not been getting piped water here at all. And the borewells, the two borewells that they had also dried up. And that's the reason why they have to depend only on buying water from the tankers. And if that cost is going to go up, it's going to take up the budget costs. Everyone complains, but what are people doing? We can complain about the government not doing anything, bureaucrats not doing anything, but yes, these citizens in fact are showing the way, not just to Chennai but to the country as well. Take a look. Everywhere you hear people complaining about others dumping garbage, others dumping plastic cover and other waste into water bodies and causing pollution, and perhaps also taking over lands. We are here in Chitlapakam, and the story here is an inspiring story for not just Chennai but for the rest of the country as well, because this is a lake where the citizens have in fact taken the initiative to desilt it, remove it with the plastic. All of you, small bunch from the huge numbers who participate here, what do you do here?
Yeah, we actually every day we gather here around 6 o'clock in the morning. Weekdays it is for 1 hour. We come here, we wear gloves and if necessary mask, and we do the cleaning of removing plastics and liquor bottles. Mostly it's all there inside the lake bed. So we remove it, we have packed it, and we have planned to move it out of the lake.
So yours is a family activity is what they were saying.
This lake is actually 54 acres of land. It is capable of storing 2000 lakhs of liter of water. See, when this lake is restored, see, 200 days we can use it for cooking and drinking purpose. This is the main...
In fact, this is an area where we saw flooding in many of these areas just 4 years ago, 4.5 years ago, let's say. And now we are talking about scarcity. And that has something like that at least served as a wake-up call for people.
Of course. See, actually, this lake, why it, the condition of the lake is because they are discharged sewage into this lake. That's what we got. Flooding is the main reason for it. Since it is almost filled with sewage, that's what we faced flood.
So all of us blame the government, sir. What is the story? What is the message that we must take from the work that all of you are doing?
When we periodically desilt the lake and the ponds, obviously, underground water gets recharged. So obviously every well, every bore well and every well will be with a good water. Whether it is we are using it or for a drinking purpose or not. Definitely there are many purposes are there
to recharge the
ground water and utilize it. So we can utilize it appropriately. There is no necessary for us to run this end to that end to get the water. Now the Chitlapakam area is totally dry. There is no water. Even 500 feet also, we are unable to get the water. It is only once the lake is desilted appropriately, water get percolated down, and definitely all those
benefits people will enjoy. You know, it's very unusual. People start off with something, but they don't sustain it. I've been seeing your group actually working for several years together. How has that managed to bring about a change? You want to tell others also this story, isn't it? We are always very cynical. Nothing will ever happen.
Yeah, complaining, you know, it is, we can do it easily. But we should have the solution. Solution, it has to come from us. From home, we have to start it. Here, no, our people are voluntarily coming. Young people, we learned lesson from young people. Those people who are working in the IT sector, they have started this movement. Then we realized, why not we support? So we have supported, and people are coming nowadays more and more. Now, entire Chitlapakam village is, it is coming under this group. And we are all, our motto is to clean our lake, and it should be kept. Restoration of water is a must. And the same should be go to everywhere. People should understand how to save water and how to protect our water bodies.
Sir, former banker and now turned an environmentalist, or should I say someone who is volunteering to save this earth?
Yes, really. I'm Hari Krishnan. I'm a retired general manager for Reserve Bank of India. So I joined this forum that we should do something for the Chitlapakam, because Chitlapakam is, the lake is the lifeline of the Chitlapakam. 60,000 residents are here. Now, the Chitlapakam earlier 30 years back, groundwater was available 5 to 6 feet. Now we are not getting water even of 100, 200, 300 feet of even go down. We don't get water because the lifeline is drying up here. This is the Chitlapakam lake. So now Chitlapakam, you see the bund height is only 3 to 4 feet. Now we have to desilt it and make it deepen so that the capacity of the water storage will be more. And more than that, the Chitlapakam, that lake contains a layer of the plastic. That is a major concern for us. That doesn't allow the water to go down. So now we are the volunteers, then we are removing every day, coming to the lake, and we are removing the plastic.
So this is a lesson for the rest of the country, and showing the way are the citizens here, and in a sense, should I say, shaming the government also into action. Or let's look at it positively and say they have also now come volunteered to say that they are going to be also desilting the lake. As we wrap up this report, I can tell you that many people here want to get away from Chennai because of this crisis. She is actually literally leaving because there is no water in your sister's place.
Actually, I wanted to stay for a week time at least. But as there is no water, I am just going back to my place.
She was telling me, in fact, before this, that she would also like to go away with her because she believes that the Chennai situation is not so good, and therefore every drop is precious. That's what they are showing, trickles that's coming from above. They are going to save that and perhaps use it for the plants as well. And waiting now for the monsoon, hopefully that should at least relieve the situation here. Time now for a short break. Lots more coming up on the other side.